Hello, everybody, and welcome back to game number three, Bowling Green State against Calvin College. My name is J. Mac Tucker, and following me along in this exciting event has been Gore Miser.
Yeah, and I mean, last game, Calvin College able to kind of come out of there and blow my mind away with their ability to kind of come back. And we were talking about it while we were looking at them as they came through, but the bands, no syllaban, not taking that one away from Coco Scones.
No, they're instead electing to take away the Cirquette, and this time the Odin, away from Thout Be Smitten. They feel that that was more of the problem than the Scylla was, but I really beg to differ here. Illy, going to go ahead and pick up that Sylvanas, knowing that both of the big anti-heal gods have been taken off the table, and now it's still waiting to see what Coco Scones is. I honestly would not be surprised to see, there it is, the Scylla has been locked in, and that's going to be going over towards the good old Coco Scones.
Now, being able to pick that one up is going to be big for them. I mean, just run it back again. They were able to kind of push that one forward like it was nothing, and now, I mean, being able to control this game that they have so far. I mean, there's no Odin, there's no Kabrakan. Wall's not looking to be a problem, but Thor going to be picked up. Cupid being hovered over here by King Med, looking to be locked in there, as well as the Sobek. So the first time we actually get to see him come through this game as well. It's going to be very, very interesting to see. I feel like, again, a lot of potential combos coming out from this one, but still, good reason we haven't really seen him.
Wow, they're going with the run back here so far. Calvin College going to be picking up that Guan Yu yet again. And whether or not this goes over to Thout Be Smitten this time around is still up in the air, because Ajax did a very good job on it last time. And you notice Thanatos was left open. Neither of these teams care. They're going to go ahead and just let the Hand of Death be on the dead swing. And Calvin College, once again, going to go with the same bans they did last time, as now they're taking out Terra once again against Bowling Green.
Yeah, both of the games that we've seen Thanatos kind of come through, not really having an impact, being able to do anything that you would want a Thanatos to be able to go forward with. The last few bans going to be coming out. And you mentioned the Terra, there's the raw healing going to be the big one. Take that away. And honestly, when you have two healers and you don't want the other team to keep up with you, that's exactly what you want to do. Running back the Guan Yu and the Sylvanas, going to allow Calvin to essentially just heal themselves as much as they did. Although it's going to be a little bit more interesting, because again, they don't quite have the same combo potential now that the Cupid is going to be on the side of Bowling Green, but there are still plenty of circles for them to choose from if they really want to. And without the Odin, I feel like it's not as necessary for them to go forward with that.
Yeah, they're going to take the Medusa off the board, really make Empyrean dig back into that god pool. We'll see if he elects to pick up his Hunter now, or wait to see what else is picked up on the side of Bowling Green to elect to go into that one. At the moment, we mentioned Guan Yu was picked up in the first round of the picking phase, and it's still kind of up in the air if Ajax is going to be running that one back, or if he's actually going to pass this one over to Thout Be Smitten. I honestly wouldn't be surprised if Ajax picked this one up yet again. Still waiting to see what pick is going to come out of Calvin College. Once again, looking for at least their Hunter and possibly either a jungler or another solo laner.
And right now looking again for that last little bit of a pickup going forward for them. And this could be a Hunter going for Empyrean, or it could be, I mean, we could see an Assassin, or like you said, we might see another Warrior or a Guardian potentially going into that solo lane. Really a lot on the board for Empyrean and his crew on Calvin here, and they're going to be looking towards this Apollo. It's going to be hovered over, and honestly, I don't mind it. I like that being picked up. Mm-hmm. I think he's going to be able to have a lot of damage and a lot of impact. And again, this kind of goes back. This is what I see Empyrean do a lot. That's going to be some good split push potential, and when team fights aren't going their way, that is exactly where he kind of defaults to. He's able to take objectives and return back what his team might have lost.
Yep, now Option's going to be back over towards Bowling Green to see what they want to pick up for their mid lane and even potentially their solo lane now. I'm really expecting Vesnar to be the one to pick up this Sobek. Dirzik actually looking to possibly take this Agni into the mid lane. A little bit of a dangerous yet safe god, as he does have that very quick dash. And with Athena being hovered in, this may actually be a Sobek going into the solo lane on the hands of Door of Wood. Although Agni was hovered, but I like the Janus just a little bit more on Dirzik. It's going to allow for a lot more safety, but yes. I mean, never mind. Don't forget anything about Janus. Agni going to be locked in alongside the Athena. Option back over to Calvin. I'd love to see the Xingqian pick up here.
I have been playing a ton of Agni lately, and it is one of those things where, like, the thing that clicked for me is I realize that there's a big reason that he hasn't been chosen, and that's just because I feel like he's just kind of been neglected. There are some other stronger mid laners right now, and while I agree, I think Giannis would be a little bit better for him, I like the CC, the control, and everything that Agni can bring to the table, and I think running some old school Smite, in fact, I think a lot of really old gods sitting on this side for Bowling Green State, whereas on Calvin, they're going to be running back a little bit of what they've had before, and it is going to be Ajax on that Guan Yu going right back into the jungle. And if he can perform the same way he did on it last game, it's looking like it could be potentially just as well without the combo really coming down from the Odin, Cupid, and honestly, Illy, and everybody just being able to lock them down in the cage with the Odin. It's going to be a little bit different here for Calvin, but I think they still have good potential being able to push themselves forward.
I do like the Agni as well, because if he does get pulled in by Illy, he does have that very quick dash to get away from the team of Calvin College there. So we're going to see just how this one works out for him as we get ready to go into our third game in this best of three set. Just got to remember, this is only the first round of the gauntlet, and we're getting some intense Smite action here. You're not going to want to miss out on the final game of this set, so stick around and see who comes out on top. Ladies and gentlemen, fellow Smite fans, welcome to game number three, Bowling Green State University tied 1-1 with Calvin College for the first round of the Ragnarok Conference. I almost forgot which conference that they were in. The Ragnarok Conference Gauntlet. My name is J-Mac Tucker, and alongside me for this exciting game three is going to be Gorm Miser.
Yeah, so far, both of these teams have shown their strength. I mean, the first game, Bowling Green were really able to kind of take it away early on. The second game, Calvin College were able to take that away early on. And right now, honestly, looking down the compositions, looking what they've brought in, I'm expecting this one to kind of stay even for a very long, more similar to the first game where we went about 10 minutes before anyone was really able to pull away. And I kind of expect to see the same thing. I think that having this Agni is going to actually allow Bowling Green to be aggressive, but stay safe at the same time because of the stun he's going to have. But that's going to be very much up to, I feel like Ajax as well as this Thor really kind of setting the pace for their mid laners.
Yeah, but as we can see, aggression already going in favor of Calvin College in all accounts right now. Dual lane has already pushed out Bowling Green. They're forced to try and clear these archers as the purple buff is being looked at here. They're going to spot the rotation here of the red buff. They're going to go ahead and let that one go. Caxidum on the chase. However, four members now trying to look here, but the root from Illy, while off the mark, was enough to deter the chase.
And now red buff going to be confirmed by Bowling Green for themselves, going to be able to kind of pick up their own things and... Honestly, Calvin College looking forward, trying to get that same aggression they had last game, but not quite able to find it because of the rotation. But I feel like that's Bowling Green just learning from their last game because they still do have the push advantage. And I think even better for Calvin College right now because not only do they have the Sylvanas, but with Apollo's passive, he will be able to throw out a little bit more auto attacks and clear that wave just a little bit faster. And they're going to be able to try and turn that one over into these Oracle Harpies.
Yeah. It looks like they will be going their way, quite possibly. At least they're going to be able to secure the first one for themselves. One of the most important things when trying to go for these Oracle Harpies is that you don't just throw all of your damage willy-nilly at them. You want to make sure to at least secure one for in the event that they walk over and try and take them away. You at least get one and split it so that way nobody gets the vision on that. Illy going to eat a Harp Bomb. Going to be dashed into taunted, stunned out by the Harp Bomb as well. Force that meditation out very early over in this lane. It's not looking the worst for him. He's going to get a nice pull onto Vesnar. Minions aren't going to be doing too much damage to him, however, and the Harp Bomb going to be off the mark from King Med.
Right now, that meditation is the same thing we saw actually force out of Vesnar in the last game early on. The pressure was so strong from Calvin College, they were able to force him to heal himself up, but not working out that way for them so far. Illy having to force that already, and it's going to allow Vesnar just a little bit of an advantage because if we see Calvin College get aggressive over here or even in any team fight that might be happening on this left-hand side, that meditation is still going to be up, whereas they have about 90 seconds left for Illy to wait. Really, I want to say the thing that's kind of surprising me the most, although a little bit unsurprising when you think about it, is the fact that Agni, having a relatively nice matchup over here against the Scylla, able to kind of out-clear because he's a little bit more early game focused than the Scylla is. And Thor, with that, allowed to kind of rotate around and help out the solo lane.
Yeah, trying to see what they can do to pressure out Valby Smitten on this Vamana is getting the advantage onto Door of Wood right now. Sobek not really known for his early game clear. Ajax just going to try and put a little bit of poke onto Dirzik, but the Talisult's going to make enough to make sure that he dashes away from that one. Gank over onto the side. Valby Smitten just going to use that dash. The wall not going to be able to connect onto that one. So Valby Smitten going to survive the first big gank of the game onto that one. And it's going to allow some more pressure in the mid lane as Coco and Ajax continuing to stick together.
very, very similar to the first game that we saw. This is kind of what's the setting the pace. You know, early on in the first game, a lot of it is which team is going to get ahead and which team can keep their head in the second game. And that was Calvin College falling behind, but they were able to kind of keep themselves focused and come back, force us into this game three scenario, but both pressure is back on. This is it. This is all they have. This is for everything on the line. Whoever loses this one gets knocked out, and you can tell from both of the teams their style of play. And honestly, it's almost like tangible tension in the air for them, just waiting patiently, not putting themselves in any kind of bad position. When you think about it, I mean, last game is on borderline getting eliminated. Calvin pulls out this 1U, who's actually going to be able to dash away and not get caught out. Going into the horse right now, trying to get the stun coming down. The horse not going to be able to outlive him, though. The dot from Agni going to be very good. Passive usage right there to get the first blood.
Yeah, I mean, that's just a textbook gank there, as Caxton was able to dunk down with that Anvil of Dawn and cut off the path. He kept Ajax trapped and pinned against that wall, nowhere for him to go. That's going to be an easy first blood on the side of Bowling Green. Get themselves rolling just a little bit quicker, but even still, Calvin College, we've been harping about this all three games. Their farm in the early stages has been phenomenal, as even with the first blood gold, Bowling Green is still down almost 400 gold.
And that's going to be big for them. Being able to keep up that farm is important, just because like last game, as long as they can stay ahead and let Coco Scones essentially do what Coco Scones wants to do, then this can work out very well for them. And allowing that Scylla through might be the thing that could put the final nail in the coffin for Bowling Green, but it's going to be up to really Illy kind of set up his mid laner right now for this early game, kind of transition to the point where we're going to be seeing these I'm a Monsters do what they were doing in the last game. But as it stands right now, I'm still kind of focusing on what we're going to see out of Datura on this Agni, just because I feel like, again, there's a lot of potential for him, but at the same time, Scylla late game out damages him by a long shot. So he's going to be kind of transitioning from this early game of not necessarily burst mage, but, you know, damage over time, flame, doing the damage, to becoming more of a, I'm going to stun you and try to get that dot on you to allow my team, specifically King Med in this case, to get those kills and find the carry that we need.
Yeah, that's going to be the difference here, is Coco is going to be looking to kill, where Dursic, while still wanting to get some kills as well, is going to be looking more towards the setup for the remainder of his team. Calvin College going to be getting a nice little group up over here on the right-hand side. No buffs to be gained from it. Just making sure that Valby Smitten doesn't get too pressured out here. Doesn't have that teleport online, so he's going to be a little bit late running back to his lane here. Ajax going to put some pressure onto Dursic in the mid lane, diving under that tower. But more than anything, just getting and allowing that farm for his mid laner.
And being able to just kind of stay under his tower again. Both teams still playing it relatively safe. And while we saw Ajax get caught out, we mentioned it earlier and we'll mention it again, Calvin College still maintain this gold lead as well as a little bit of an experience lead, but both of them very, very small at this point. Bowling Green still in a position to kind of swing that away. I mean, the experience is actually flopping between the two teams back and forth. The two-man taunt gonna be coming down. The gas gonna come through. The stun on the Coco Skill's gonna be good. The heal and the pull coming out. The knockup gonna be good. Crux trying to do the damage. Vesnar trying to get away, but I'm a Monster gonna confirm that. Put Coco Skill's on board immediately, using that second shot to be able to clear out those archers, get a little bit of extra farm. But that is the start that he wants as the Scylla.
I mean, that's just textbook Scylla right there. Got off the Sikkim, threw down the Crush, didn't pop it immediately because Crush does provide that extra magic protection shred when you use that ultimate. So held onto it until he was ready to go down, then popped the Crush into the Alma Monster, or even vice versa there. Was regardless able to get the reset for it. And as you said, just immediately using it to clear out those waves. Now Koga going to go towards his red buff, try and clear that one up for him. Actually, it already has been dropped. Didn't show it on the map for him, but able to pick that one up for him now, give himself a little bit more magical power. And once again, be able to be healed up by this double healer.
A big pickup for that kill, though, right there for Calvo. Now being able to kind of bring that gold lead in their favor a little bit more comfortably. Now sitting at about 1,000 gold instead of the 400. Now we see Thor taking a little bit of poke, and this is going to be interesting. Bowling Green actually have a more kind of level 5 to level 10 centered synergy going between their mid and jungle, but not quite having that impact because of the way this Guan Yu and the Sylvanas are being run. And honestly, when it comes down to it, how greatly performing Coco Scones is on the Scylla, being able to hit the roots, the Sikkims, everything that he needs to kind of set himself up, as well as, you know, with the help of Illy here on the Sylvanas. And so far, it's been going well for them, and I expect to see it kind of continue down this path similar to last game.
A little bit of a slap box over at the Oracles. They're going to split those ones one to one. Kingben was able to make that rotation in and take away one of them from Empyrean. So Empyrean going to be split down onto that one. Red buff going to be dropped and given over to Dzirzik there. He keeps trying to walk over to it to make sure he can pick that one up. Purple buff going to be dropped as well for Bowling Green. Now Empyrean doing what he can to try and apply some pressure. Double tap not going to connect from Caxton. So it's going to just be enough for him to instead clear up the wave. Ajax going to pick up that speed buff and meet up with Coco Scones here. Actually, I'm going to go back to his back camp. And really, that's going to be the end of that engagement over on that left-hand side for now.
And right now, I mean, again, just kind of checking in on the solo lane since we haven't really been peeking out over there, but it's going to be much of the same that you would really expect. A slap fight between two tanky targets, both of them not having mana, both of them just farming, going to be backing to their bases, teleporting right back into where they go. And really, what I'm looking at is we have a minute until the portal demon spawns, the last set of elementals, not quite the last set, but going to be picked up by Coco Scones there, who's trying to farm up as much as he can. Both mid laners on both teams at 1-0 currently. And I mean, really, when it comes down to it, Ajax, the only one who's found a death on his team, whereas the support on the other side. So ultimately, I mean, still coming out as a wash. 40 seconds before I feel we'll see maybe any really big aggression. But I mainly expect to see some fights over on the left-hand side, more for the Gold Fury than for the Portal Demon once it spawns.
Just look at the graph chart right now. Once again, Calvin College out farming Bowling Green right now. It's a 1-1 game, but they're sitting up almost 1,200 gold at the time. Where is this all coming from? How are they farming so... They're just farming so efficiently at this point.
A lot of it has been picking up just kind of the neutral camps when it comes down to it. Grabbing the mid camps, grabbing the elementals, grabbing the Oracle Harpies. And when you do that enough times, you're able to get that. But a lot of it is kind of the experience sharing, I feel, that they're doing a proper grouping with every single camp to make sure that they maximize what they're able to get out of that. And really, when it comes down to it, I'm wondering if it comes down, I mean, this is going to be a weird kind of thing to highlight, but the support boots, when it comes down to it, we have Athena who's able to travel a lot, but because of that, I feel like they've been spending a lot of time in the jungle, not necessarily farming, whereas on the other side with those reinforced shoes, Illy's, while he's not getting quite as much for getting aggressive onto gods, he is still going to be kind of hovering around with his mid and jungle just a little bit more because he's not going to be, you know, speed tree. He's not going to be able to get out too easily. As Coco Scones leading a double tap to the face, the pull coming out, Crush going to be going down, hitting two right now, four, half day, how, but Coco Scones forced to fall back immediately, and now Ajax trying to run away using those beats already, but I feel like he's going to be the next target, although Athena going forward right now, it could be Coco Scones. Ajax still in trouble, going to be able to heal himself up just a little bit, dashing forward, just trying to get away, but Thor going deep, now caught in the line.
Gonna be caught out there. Dwarfwood gonna throw that, be smitten into the back, and that's gonna be the end of that one there. Coco Scones kind of really baiting him more than anything else by sticking around as long as he did. Dash is gonna be out from Vesnar, but he's gonna get yanked into the back, and Coco Scones gonna pick up the unofficial double. Dzirzik gonna find the return kill, and now Dwarfwood caught in the middle of three, forced to use that tail whip to spread the team apart and make sure that he can get out of that one no problem. So 2-for-1 engagement in favor of Calvin College.
And Calvin College, I mean, losing Scylla is bad, but I mean, already I'm looking at that, you know, slash line. You look at it, KD, 3-1-0 already. Last game, I believe we got to see him go to 3-1-3 after that first death. So really, I expect to see something kind of similar as we see Scylla coming online a little bit more. And soon we're going to be seeing Empyrean have a much larger impact. Again, Apollo known more, I guess, kind of for his late game split push potential. And honestly, a lot of fighting, and actually accidentally going to leash that one Oracle Harpy, and because of that loses it, one auto away right there. Empyrean, just a small misplay right there, losing a little bit of farm and experience, but he's the one who I'm going to highlight overall. And right now with the Ikaval online, once he starts building into a little bit more damage, I expect to see him be making more impactful rotations.
I mean, I'm looking at the fact that Coco Scones once again going into this very potential second item Soul Reaver yet again. It provided a lot of power and pressure for him in that game, but Empyrean forced to go into the skies. The rotation from Gaxton was good, forced out ult for ult onto that one, but Empyrean's going to be able to get away, go all the way back to base just about. He ran out of mana, couldn't quite get all the way to the back there, but going to trade out the Hunter ult for Gaxton. I'm not sure if that's 100% worth. I mean, yes, Empyrean's is going to take a little bit longer to come online, but that's a lot of mid lane pressure that's been taken off the board.
And that's going to be the big thing right there. While Empyrean, I mean, most of the time we see Apollo, there's two reasons to use that ultimate. One is as a getaway, as we just saw it. And the other one is, I've been split pushing your tier 2. I just got it, and my team needs me in the team fight, so I'm coming back across the map. Whereas Thor, like you said, a lot of pressure coming out of that one, a lot of abilities to kind of shut down anybody. And we're going to see Calvin College not get the pulls, going to leash away that gold fairy, but still aggress on the King Med. Going to use that dash to get away right now. And Heart Bomb going to come out, potentially with the stun. Ajax reading that one, going to walk away from his teammates just to make sure he does not spread that. But now we have the rotation. Bowling Green has set up. They recognize the gold fairy is going to be started. Now this is going to be the aggression. Ajax going in.
Yeah, he's going to go in, trying to figure out who's starting. He's going to land onto King Med. The hammer's going to be okay from Caxism, but the knockback from Illy is going to be even better. Rathatera is going to hit onto two members. The bomb is going to be good, and that's going to be enough to take down Illy. Dursa gets the first kill in the engagement. Last bomb being thrown out, but he's just being stomped on by Thou Beast Smitten. Ajax continuing aggression forward. The dash is going to be good to get him out, and so it's going to be a 1-for-0 exchange. Four members also not too pretty right now, especially Ajax and Coco sitting a little too low to continue the aggression. They're going to be able to back off of that one. Everybody just kind of backing off to heal.
And again, kind of coming out as a wash overall. Losing Illy is going to be bad for Calvin College, though. And now we see Thor going in deep, trying to get Coco Scones, able to confirm that kill, no problem. That'll be Smitten going in, but the Tom going to be good, saving his teammate effectively there, depending on the pathing that we're going to be seeing coming out of the Thor. Vesnar getting chased down, but it's not going to be enough. That'll be Smitten forced to fall back right there. 14 minutes into the game going back and forth and back and forth. And what we were saying earlier was Calvin College having a lead, but now experience in favor of Bowling Green. Honestly, gold. 300 separates the two teams. It's essentially negligible. No team really has a distinct advantage.
No, I mean, this is just how it's been with these two teams, all three of these games, up until the 15 to 20 minute mark. It's been relatively even amongst them. I mean, kill-wise and then just gold and experience more than anything else. The big difference really coming out for, I mean, for advantage of Bowling Green, it's in the mid lane. They got a two-level lead on to Coco Scones right now, which is something that they didn't have last game, was Coco was always kind of on top of the field there. To be able to go to these Oracle Harpies, Illy not going to be able to secure those ones, so Bowling Green going to get a little bit of neutral objective in their favor, getting that free vision of the Gold Fury. Now they're looking to get a potential invade here as the mid guys are going to be dropped. Going to drop into the air. Coco Stone's going to get the reset. I'm a monster. Going to be stunned out by the horse, and that's going to be the next death of the game. Dursa going to take that one. Coco Stone's forced to use that Aegis so he doesn't die to the Fields of Love from the Cupid. And now 2-4-0. Calvin College now going to look towards the Gold Fury.
As a big rotation coming out from the Cupid, to have that presence of nine, King Med throwing down that ult was very good. Unfortunately for him, that Aegis being online does allow Coco Scones to live through. Heal back up almost to full already, and now being able to grab that Gold Fury is going to be able to put Calvin College back on the board in the lead right now, shifting that over to them essentially 2 minutes right after we were saying they were dead even. Now being able to control that and turn again, once again, right after the Gold Fury, immediately to a tier one tower, get that map objective and get that map control. Wood have complete of it, and now Door of Wood trying to do whatever he can in the Lurking the Waters. A lot of damage onto Illy, gonna be able to get that kill, but now he's in between four of them with Apollo come crashing down, but Thor comes crashing down as well. All of them just trying to live through this one. Door of Wood taking a lot of damage, Vistnar coming down, but the stun gonna be coming out from Ajax relatively soon, trying to get that damage down. It's gonna be another kill. Ajax barely able to get out of there. Vesnar dashing forward, looking for the setup, but ultimately kind of putting himself in a bad spot. The wall not gonna be good from Thor, and I feel like this is gonna be kind of just complete disengage from Calvin College. A nice knockup from Valby Smitten. Again, just kind of pulling this one away. And ultimately, I believe Calvin College still coming out with the win overall.
It's just funny seeing those little interactions. King Med turning around to get the dash off, but instead Valby Smitten's taking a little bit of priority there, going to knock him up out of that one. But, I mean, that was just a case of Illy sticking around a little too long inside that tower. Took a little bit too much damage. Dwarf Wood able to make that good rotation over. Have the mindset to pick up that one, but just going to trade out one for one. Support for solo, not necessarily worth, as they were also able to pick up that tier one tower. Calvin College now extending their lead to about 3,000 gold. This is the first significant lead we've really seen all game.
And they're going to be able to kind of turn that again. We're looking at Coco Scones going immediately into that Soul Reaver to get that extra little bit of damage on the other side. Seeing a little bit of an unorthodox build for mid lately, but a pretty much spot on Agni build going for that Bancroft's Talon, the Obsidian Shard, as well as the Shoes of the Magi this early on, just to kind of give him that lifesteal and that damage to go forward, as we're going to see the two-man hunt come down. The wall was good, but it's not going to be good enough to save their life. Rathatera going to hit three right now. Vesnar caught out, trying to just zone for his team and age. Ajax chasing down Thor, but not able to find the kill. And Door of Wood, one more time, kind of caught out. Both teams not going to continue their aggression, just completely fall back.
I mean, once again, it's Coco Stone's falling down to half HP or less, and now by the end of the engagement, he's back up to full. A second heal from Illy is going to be enough to tap him off onto that one. He's just going to go back to farming more than anything. And this has kind of been the problem in these last few fights, is they haven't been able to just kill Coco Stones outright. And that's the big downside of this Agni pick, is you lack the big one-shot burst. You kind of have to sustain poke it out. Oracle Harpy's going to be dropped by Calvin College, as well as the mid camp. And looking over at to Ajax's build, we mentioned kind of interesting startups here, and we have the Shield of Regrowth second into a Titan's Bane. How do you feel about this?
Well, it's going to be interesting. So the Titan's Bane is going to work out really well for him overall. His Coco Stone's going to get taken down, but Illy Ajax is going to be the return kills right now. I mean, three down for Calvin and Gary, and caught out, forced to go into the ult, but he's not going to be able to make it there. That's going to be four kills right there on the board for Bowling Green. Double kill for King Med. One tower, probably two towers, even though that'll be spent making a rotation over. Probably recognizes that this is going to be a death trap if he walks into this the wrong way. Coming into the back line, though, going to be looking for anything. He is tanky, he is Vamana, and he's going to use that dash to get out of there, because once four members turn their eyes onto you, you get a little bit scared, and that is the right play, falling back right there and potentially being able to come back and try and steal one of these objectives.
Especially with all five members up and perfectly healthy. Portal Demon is awake, but Dalby Smitten gonna steal it with the Umbrella Ring. The North American objective secure is not very good for them. Illy's gonna walk through the portal and pick up three members with that Wrath of Terror. And now Ajax looking to turn his sights over to King Med. Gonna land on top of the Aegis. Gonna avoid the damage for it. He's gonna be able to dash away, but Coco's going to see her. Sigmund's gonna miss. Crush not gonna connect either. And so that's gonna be King Med getting out alive. No problem there. And now all five members of Calvin College have finally made it over to this right side.
That was the ultimate guess who's back right there. Being able to confirm that portal, his team just drop ships right into the fight and is able to kind of just say, hey, Bowling Green, by the way, we're still in this match ready to fight you. We still have a little bit of a lead. You may have been able to put a huge dent in it right there with that last push, but we are not done fighting just yet. And continuing that one 20 minutes into the game, just showing at the graphs. I mean, there's a huge story. You see it kind of going in Bowling Green's favor, skyrocketing to Calvin College as they were able to kind of get that Gold Fury, win some fights there. And immediately you see the four kills and the two towers picked up by Bowling Green and the return fight coming down. So right now, Gold still in favor of Calvin College, experience in favor of Bowling Green, both sitting at about 1,000 going back and forth. And really, it kind of levels out while the level advantage is just slightly in Bowling Green's favor. We do have some more items online for Calvin College overall, and they're going to be able to turn that into their objective and immediately just come out. These teams are still even for what it's worth, and 20 minutes in, they are just looking for whatever they can to put themselves ahead. This Gold Fury that Bowling Green has started is going to be the good first step.
I mean, I can only imagine what would have happened in that fight if Coco Scones had showed up just a split second earlier. If he would have come through that portal at almost the same time as Illy, that could have potentially turned into a two-kill exchange on there. The Wrath of Terra plus with the Sikkim now applying to three targets because of the level that it's at, they could have potentially gotten a couple of pickoffs there. Dalby Smitten going to try and chase down Dora of Wood over in this solo lane, getting some good damage out, trying to get them to force some kind of rotation over here. Otherwise, Dalby Smitten may be able to look towards taking this tower, but they're just going to kind of sit around, not really do too much here, just get a little bit of farm online. And as we said, this game is essentially dead even with the golden experience.
And right now, it looks like Illy's trying to steal something away. Not able to find those Oracle Harpies, though. Bowling Green may be able to confirm that, get that vision. They already have the Gold Fear. They're not too worried right there. And Agni, though, forced to use his beads and dash to get away right there. And that actually gave me a couple of reminiscing moments from back when that dash did have CC immunity for Agni. But now sitting in a little bit more of a precarious position, forcing that beads out already, I feel like he's another big target here on Tzurek. But he's been having a little bit more of an impact as we've gotten into this game now, using that stun, using that utility to set up King Med and the rest of his team to kind of pick up those kills for him and apply that dot damage again, just to try and help his team out in these team fights. And so far it's working. He's not going to be as impactful as Coco Scones, but is still going to be able to help them out. And honestly, I feel like that's going to be a big turnaround. If there's a large group up from Calvin College, that is his time to shine with a big AoE stun.
Yeah, Bowling Green needs to do what they can to also stick around Vesnar as much as they can, as he does finish off that Gauntlet of Thieves. Going to provide a lot of AoE protections to his team. As mentioned back in the first game, these triple aura items picked up from the Guardian, from the support player, is doing wonders for them. It's allowing them to stay alive a little bit longer with that HP 5 that Sovereignty provides, and just from the protections overall more than anything else. Pyrian getting aggressive over in this left-hand side against King Med, trying to get some tower damage off there more than anything. Pyrian just trying to apply pressure, but that's going to go in favor of Calvin College, because if something goes down, Pyrian can just ult over into the team fight, and that's something that we talked about quite extensively early on.
And that's going to be very big for them. Of course, they do have the advantage on Bowling Green that they've been trying to force that out, and so far they were able to do so a couple times. The last time they were actually able to find the kill before he was able to get away. But right now, Bowling Green looking to lose their speed buff. Going to be picked up, but the blood going to be good on the Illy right now. Thor going up into the air looking for something. Coco Scones in the Animal Monster with that CC immunity. Not going to be the main target right now. I'm trying to outlive the Thor ult. Going to be going to throw down that, but comes Thor crashing down in the backline. Here comes Empyrean, just like you had said, going in, trying to get the damage down for his team. Coco Scones with the Animal Monster offline. Now Ajax trying to heal himself just to stay alive, but it looks like the aggression from Bowling Green going to continue forward. But Tatsura going to be the first one to fall. Agni not able to save his own life with the stun and dash. But when I look over at that left-hand lane, King Med going to continue this split pushing. It opens up. Portal Demon about to respawn. Fire Giant is up, and I expect Calvin College to try and get aggressive over here, but they're still trying to fight right now, and that'll be Smitten going to pay for it with his life.
Not able to get up into that big baby form in time. And now, speaking of the baby, as you said, he's still continuing to split push over on this left-hand side, and nobody is going over there to stop as the Portal Demon is going to be spawning. Vesnar wants to see if he can try and get a cheeky steal for his team onto this one, but they need to send somebody back quick, because Vesnar has the mindset to tell him, hey, there's everybody still here, but instead King Med's going to elect to just take the tier 2 tower and go ahead and go back to base. Portal Demon was taken by Calvin College, going to get a little bit of golden experience onto their side, but now Bowling Green, they do have the advantage in this game with that last fight, able to bring themselves up to almost 3,000 experience and about 2,000 gold to their coffers. It's going to help them out just a little bit. As we've said, experience has always kind of been in their favor this game.
And honestly, when I'm looking at it, the difference between last game and this game for Calvin College is going to be those last two picks, the Vamana. While it's still kind of performing around the same way we saw with the Odin, the cage isn't there to set up the rest of his team, and the big one is going to be Empyrean. While he does have Apollo and he's playing it very well, at this point in the game last time, he was able to have 4-3 kills online with the rest of his team kind of being able to help carry along with Coco Scones and not quite having the same impact on this Apollo. And I kind of feel like he's lacking just a little bit of power overall. The Hasten Fatalis not quite as necessary overall for the Apollo, just because of the fact that he does have that attack speed steroid in his kit for his passive, but still picking that up, still focusing on being able to kind of win these boxing matches. Right now, I feel like King Med, just a slight advantage overall for the Hunter.
Yeah, he's going to be able to provide a little bit more when he does join these team fights, that big AoE cripple over anything else, comparatively to Empyrean, who his big advantage is going to be utilizing that split push and then coming back into the team fight. We saw in that last one, and he really didn't make that much of an impact, where King Med was just like, oh, well, he's gone. I can't make it over in time. You guys good? Cool. I'm just going to take these two towers in return for it. And that's what really spiked it into Bowling Green's favor, is they didn't need King Med. You know, only one person was going to be dying from that one. So just allow him to continue the push over on that left-hand lane. But now we're looking over on the right-hand side, and they're looking for the next big fight, which could determine who's going to get this Fire Giant.
And King Med going to be able to get a little bit of poke down. That'll be Smitten forced to use his dash already just to fall back. But like you said, everyone just kind of sitting back trying to figure out what they're going to be doing. Heal's going to be good for Calvin College here, being able to heal up after this disengage. And with a long lull time, that's exactly what they need to kind of go forward. Moving into this, I am going to be again highlighting Tatsurik. If he can hit some big AoE stuns, that can change the pace of the game for his team. On the other side, I'm looking at Illy and Ajax. Get the stuns, get the knockups, set up Coco Scones for a perfect Animal Monster. Allow him to hit the squishy targets he needs to hit, erase them off the board, and turn this around. Don't really need to focus down the Agni as much as it is the Cupid and the Thor. That has been the big pain for them. Door of Wood has an impact, Vesnar has an impact, but they're both tanks. You're not going to take them down as easily. I'm looking to take down the carries as fast as they can, and if they can push themselves forward there, they're going to be able to confirm that Fire Giant and potentially pull this game right back in their favor. Although right now they're still sitting down, like you had said, about 2,000 of everything, experience and gold, just patiently waiting to try and find themselves in a good spot.
They're waiting to see who's going to make the first mistake, but none of them have really recognized that Illy is not in the area just yet. He went back to base, was able to finish off that wing blade. That's really going to allow him to get away from this Sobek Door of Woods. Kind of been a thorn in his side, and also be able to get out of the Cupid ultimate, as it does provide a slow onto that one. He's going to be granting slow immunity from it, allow him to get away from that one more than anything else. But now, once again, all 10 members grouped over onto this right-hand side. Caxton making his rotation back in as he went back to base in order to finish up what looked to be a Titan's Bane to provide a little bit more damage on the side of that Thor. And let's take a look at the player damage while we're in this little bit of a lull. As you can see, Zerzik has topped the player damage charts almost at 15,000 right now. Next one behind him is going to be Valby Smitten and Scylla, piloted by Kokosh Cones, sitting at just a little bit lower, not quite the damage numbers that we had last game. And Dirzik finally being able to provide those, as he was very low on that Thoth last game.
Yeah, and that's going to be, I think, just kind of the impact of having that damage over time and being a little bit safer to apply that. Right now, he's not getting focused down as much because of the low impact that Agni is going to have. And honestly, because he hasn't quite fully been in the fight each time, I think one of the things I've been mentioning is how much I want to see these big AoE stuns, and he just quite hasn't been able to pull that. And right now, I mean, I'm going to tell you, between these two teams, it's starting, like, you can feel the tension growing just because you realize that they're dancing around this fire giant. Portal Demon's about to come up. Gold Fury has respawned, but they haven't been aggressing. They've all been kind of falling back farming, and there hasn't been a single fight.
No, I mean, it's just been...
No one wants to make that mistake. No one wants to be the one who loses this set for their team.
No, I mean, this is the big issue that was with Calvin Collins last time, was they were too quick to jump the gun on these big objectives, and that's what cost them their set against Southwestern. They're not going to make the same mistake this time around. As you said, nobody wants to be the one who ends up losing this for the team because of the mistake. Five-man grouping here for Bowling Green, only three, now four joining the midst, and Valby Smitten on his way over. They're just playing it very patiently, taking buffs as they spawn, taking mini objectives when they can, just waiting to see who is going to make the first move.
Right now, honestly, I'm kind of looking at Empyrean, who can, at this point in the game, do exactly what we're saying during picks and bans. He could leave this completely behind the minute his team needs him, hit that four, fly on over, but he could be trying to push down a tower right now, whereas it looks like the team has decided that they are done waiting. They are going to be the ones who force that aggression, pulling over Bowling Green to that right hand side. They're going to be going, but now we're looking at Thor going to come crashing down. Coco Scopes going to be the first one to get aggressed on, but really going to be able to make it out of there because it's similar right now. Illy trying to do as much as he can, trying to get the damage down, but Coco Scone's going to be the first one to fall. Ajax trying to get out of all of this, but really falling low, and King Med going to be able to pick up that one. This is going to be the team fight they need. Three kills picked up right there, and that is what they really needed to be able to push themselves forward. Valby Smitten is still alive. Empyrean is still alive. But that opens up Portal Demon, Fire Giant, Gold Fury, and that last two set of towers on this right-hand land.
And Bowling Green is going to take the smart option for now. Start off with the Portal Demon. Dwarfwood did aggro the Fire Giant. Not a big deal, as they're going to have a three-man back to the base. Make that four, as Dwarfwood now going to be going back along with the rest of his team. It's going to allow them to come back in no problem. There is a ward up there for Calvin College, but there's no real aggression that's going to come from it. Savvy Spin's the only one in the area. Fire Giant has been started up, and I don't think they made the realization. Now King Med has spotted out Savvy Spin, forced him to run away. He doesn't have the big baby. He is going to get the stun off of that Mantle of Discord, and now the team of Bowling Green is turning tail to see what they can do. Got to go over is Caxton to make sure that the baby is eliminated. Empyrean just circling in the air, waiting for the opportunity to come down as they're trying to burst down this Fire Giant. Bowling Green is going to secure it, and Empyrean's going to pay with his life as the timing was not on point for him. And now only three members left for Calvin College as they finally respawn, but only to witness their Tier 1 tower in solo fall, and very shortly after the Tier 2.
And now with five members strong, pushing down this lane, all healing from the Fire Giant buff, and after being able to control pretty much every team fight that has happened since then, this game has gone from even to completely in Bowling Green's pocket, now sitting with 6,000 gold in the lead, and looking to continue that even further as we hear Thor going up into the air. Coco Scones completely erased off the board. Illy going to be taken down. Ajax going to be taken down, leaving this Phoenix exposed. Deicide, 15 seconds, and there will be a Vamana around, but that doesn't seem like it's going to be much for Bowling Green. They're going to pour right into the Titan here, try to confirm this game three and move themselves forward and eliminate Calvin College.
South Bowling Green State University, while looking shaky in that second game, have brought it back together, winning that last big team fight to decide the game. confirms game three and their shot at moving forward in the gauntlet stage. They're going to be taking on Ohio State University as their next big target, and that's going to be a difficult one for them. That is Shaka's team. He is going to be available for play today, and now it's going to determine who will be moving forward as well later on next week. The winner of Bowling Green and Ohio will play Stony Brook University. But going back into this game, it was that last team fight. Caxicum went in first. He was the initiation for his team, and the beautiful wall, more than anything else, was what secured it for them as King Med was able to catch three members inside of that Field of Love.
And a lot coming down to really Thor all coming down, focusing out Coco Scones. They recognized, okay, we let the Scylla through. They picked it up again on Calvin. Let's just not let him get to where he was last game. Last game, he was able to kind of control that. I believe he was at like 6-0-6 at one point, 6-1-6 at one point. And Coco Scones this game, 4-5-2, like you had said early on, not the same numbers we were seeing, not exactly the performance he was able to pull out in that first game. And a lot of that was on the back of Dutsurek and Caxitum there, just stopping him from getting where he was in the last game. And I feel like, again, picks and bans, Bowling Green were able to kind of control what was giving them the most trouble in that last game, and being able to shut down the last thing that ticked him over was that Scylla. And ultimately, like you said, that one team fight, they took him out early on. He wasn't able to get any damage out, and they took the fight.
Yeah, I mean, that was the name of it. Get Coco Scones out of the fight. Get him away from the team, and he's going to be picked off easy. It is a tiny little Scylla. They don't have any kind of major defense. There's no HP built into Scylla. There's no defensive options here. It's just pure damage on the side of Coco. And that was the downside, was as soon as Caxum came down, got off the combo, teleported back over to where Scylla had used the Sentinel. I mean, he was dead to rights. There was just nothing that Coco could do in that instance. And Durzik, Cactum, and Kingmed all coming up big in that game. And as we said, it was the Thor wall from Cactum locking three members inside of that Fields of Love that really sealed the deal for that one. Picking up three, getting the portal demon, coming back to get the return fire giant with two more kills to boot. And then it was just all said and done from that one as they were able to push up, kill off the final three, and take the Titan.
And as it means, what that goes forward for him is Bowling Green move up in this bracket. Calvin College, unfortunately for you, are eliminated. And while you played well, and honestly, I mean, that's probably one of the second three-game sets we've been able to see kind of throughout the entire season. Of course, going back, they've given us a lot of good games, and it's a little bittersweet to see you leave, but I'm looking forward to what Bowling Green has to show as they move forward through their bracket right now, and it's looking like it is going to be, honestly, some great sets all across the board. I mean, if we're starting out, this was only round one, and we still have to go through two, three, four, and ultimately that those last sets in round four are going to be the top two teams from each conference just fighting it out for that last spot in the bracket.
Yeah, I mean, the gauntlet is just beginning, and we have a lot more action for you guys as for the gauntlet stage. We're only going through two rounds of gauntlets, but we're going to try and show off as many games as those as we can today. So stick around. We're going to be back with our next game of the evening. You're not going to want to miss these sets, so we will be right back. Stay tuned.